Morning, guys. Been a couple of days since the video, but haven't been doing a hell of a lot. Just gonna warm the truck up and close the doors because why are they open? One moment. Yeah, here. There we go. I think. There we go, it's out of gear. Hang on. I'll just sit you there. You can wait a second. Well, now that he's running, should idle. Maybe. Maybe. Yeah, we're good. No, we're not good. Damn it. There we go. Just give it a little bit of hand throttle. So yeah, I just went and picked up this Commodore yesterday. Just another one to flip like I did with that wagon. So it's a good little car, little two owner, 200,000 Ks BP Calais. So it's got the independent rear end and all the options, electric windows and stuff, which is pretty good for a 92. Can't get out of my gate because that's just how it is. There we go. But yeah, the car itself is pretty tidy. It's, you know, all factory wheels, bit of sunburn here and there, but I'll give it a tidy up and see what it's worth to someone. Should be worth a little bit of money to a collector, but just gonna head round to Reeces and help him get his VT sorted so that we can put this in his shed. And from there, we can assess the damage. Apparently it's got a blown head gasket. So, it came with a gasket kit, so if that's all it is, we'll put the heads off, do the head gasket, do all the other gaskets while we're at it. And someone should get a nice, crisp, ready to go for another million Ks Commodore. Because that's what Commodores do, apparently. Apart from the skid one wheel. They should really, really send them. Just close my gate. Hang on. But yeah, so that's the plan for today. Hope to get Reeces VT all going. He's been having issues with the gearbox, not selecting gears or not working under load. So, new recon box, new sensors, and that should do it. I'll see you around then. Jump out into the future because that's how it is, and we'll put a motor in. So, no worries. Yeah, motor's here, box attached, in, out, gone. See ya.
Well, it's that elimination process, you know what I mean? Like, you start sitting there going, what kind of ratio you want?
Without touching the top, if it needs adjusting, you've got to wiggle it just a little bit from the base, like this, and then come down.
Okay?
Yeah. Yep.
Come down slowly.
There you go. Perfect. We need to lower this down a little bit to drop that in. Hear that?
Ooh.
So now you need to go under the car and put those two nuts on the bottom of that engine mount. So under the car, come down here with me. They're up in there. Other two things. Yours is weird, man.
Yeah, you need like a whatever they are, 15 mm tube socket. These are different, eh?
I just did a VT and it was nothing like this.
Yeah. I always wondered if mine was a slap together car. Does that make sense?
Like, mine was identical to the VS. Motor's in. Reese is having a nap because that's what he does. But, yeah, motor's in, so we'll bolt off the engine, mounts, the exhaust, rest will do the gearbox crossmember, plug it in and push it out because it's not going to drive.
That front one.
That one? Yeah. I don't want that one. That one will be a bear. That's a good one.
Need to get one of those VTs with the ABS delete. Almost. Almost. I've got an ABS delete.
Yeah, what on the burnout one, eh?
Yeah.
Don't you need cert once you delete it?
No.
Fuck, I shouldn't have done that.
Just sort the dash.
Hey?
Sort the dash.
Oh, real?
Yeah. Well, no ABS load on the dash, eh? Are you right there?
Nah. Might have to unlisten that side a bit.
Nah?
Nah?
I can if I have to, but I don't want to.
You give it a go.
Okay, hang on.
So you know how like you've had your experience with the roll cage? This is mine. This is where I went.
Yep. Nice cross-threaded bolt on the flange. But it's okay. I broke it.
Yeah.
Have you done the crossbeam move?
Nah, I thought I'd, because I didn't want to push it in while you were underneath it, if that makes sense.
No drama. So I find a nut and bolt to go through that. Could probably just use a Ecotec or a Buick exhaust stud from the manifold and just put a nut on the other side of it.
Hey, that's not a bad idea.
Should be one here somewhere. Random forks and the random bolt bins. I will find something shortly. I'll come back and watch you struggle first.
That's the one.
Buy a mint VT. This one's for sale. As it sits, 10k. If we get it going, 2.5. Are you winning?
Getting there. Almost. Far off.
Bring back carbies, eh?
Bring back, yeah. That's why the runner's gonna stay fucking calibrated.
Can you carby an alias?
Yeah.
Can you carby an alias?
You can actually. Well,
you can carby a barrier as well. I think that'd be more fun.
That would. I think that's not expensive to do either.
No, it's not.
Have you seen one though? Have you looked?
I looked at the manifolds to get them out of Aussie. Watch the wheel, it'll spin.
Ah, fucking hell. No, no. So not used to them being under the cape frame.
What's that?
The axle stands.
Ah, well you did it.
Yeah.
What are you wanting, the loom?
Nah, I'm trying to position it. I get my other hand to lift it. Oh, no, that's your moon boot.
Yeah, no, you can kick that, that's fine.
I can't.
I've got my hand on it, so I can't go far.
Alright, I'll try to find the ratchet.
Up close and personal starter install.
Oh, real?
Yeah.
Okay, sweet.
Get this loom on the back of the starter. Maybe, if I can do it with one hand.
Exactly what I fucking need.
Oh, God, did I just drop a nut on you?
Nah.
Oh, oh no, I see it.
You wouldn't be able to see it. You don't have a big extension. Doesn't have to be long. Just.
I'm about to drop a nut on you.
What side of? Oh fuck.
Will it start? This is the big question. Will it spit water everywhere? Will it spit fluid? Will it fall off the axle stands? Will it be loud? Yeah, it will.
That one's a given.
So you want me to roll under and see if that drive shaft spins? Is the key on? It will be, steering lock.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. So it's like full on too.
Yeah, that'll do it.
That's like, hey.
Oh, you're lucky. Still getting the video.
I figured that much. We
couldn't work out why it wouldn't turn over. And then Reece decides to remember that we're missing just a couple of fuses onto it. Let's go. It's as muddy as. Cool way.
Oh, it's a bit dark.
Yeah.
Right, my light doesn't want to work, but I'll just talk through the dark. Tried firing Reeces VT, but the fuel pump seems to have shit itself. So we're already getting that sus tomorrow. So I've still got the VP on the back of the truck. We'll sort out Reeces one tomorrow. All signs are pointing in the right direction that it's going to be working, which is cool. I'll swap the fuel pump, get it started, make sure the trans is engaging, get the drive shaft in, and get it out of the little sheds, get in, get the heads off the Calais, and make a start. It's going to be a bit of a learning curve. I've pulled motors apart, but I've never had to put them back together. But yeah, I will talk to you soon. Ciao.